So in this particular module, we will learn about what are inner sphere type of reactions and how are they different from outer sphere reactions. At least one labile complex for electron transfer via inner sphere pathway will be learned. General mechanism for Tobe's classical reaction and closely associated reactions will also be discussed. The mechanistic pathways strongly recommend requirement of the bridging ligand. This will be understood by going in details. So, as far as introduction to the mechanism of redox reaction via inner sphere pathway is concerned, the inner sphere reactions are those which incorporate sharing or bridging of the ligand, at least one ligand, for the electron transfer process, and the reactants undergo change in complementary oxidation state. The reactants join together to result a single primary bond system through adopting ligand bridging pathway. There are two significant points for inner sphere mechanisms that take place. The first one is complex having at least one ligand with secondary binding site that is sterically favorable to the second metal ion, that is desirable but not compulsory. Second is complex receiving the ligand must be labile enough in terms of expanding the coordination number at the time of electron transfer. Therefore, such reactions can be considered to be mediated by bridged ligand. Unlike to that for outer sphere type of mechanism that we have discussed in previous two modules, the coordination sphere of the complex participates in the inner sphere mechanism and atom or group or ion transfer takes place. So, as a whole, inner sphere mechanisms involve the transfer of atoms, groups or ions, and it is also considered electron transfer because the atom or group of ion goes or departs from one complex to another taking its own electron with it. So, despite satisfying above mentioned terms and conditions, the reactants may still adopt a lower energy pathway, that is outer sphere mechanism. Therefore, a convincing evidence for inner sphere route is required. Although the variation in mechanistic plausibility have been numerously argued to support whether the reaction is inner sphere or outer sphere. However, the direct evidences are still lacking to prove whether it is going through the inner sphere pathway. The argument came to end after the detailed and evident experiment performed by Taube and Mayers employing several ligands that were obviously detected in the product. Indeed, the bridging or shared ligand is not initially connected with the coordination sphere of the metal center. Eventually, the inertness of product governs the inner sphere redox reaction time scale. The inert sphere reactions are of considerable importance because of their widespread applications. For instance, beside universal use of chromium 2 as a reductant, Fe hexa aqua 2 plus complex, cobalt hexa cyanide 3 minus complex, vanadium hexa aqua 2 plus complex, and ruthenium pentaamine water 2 plus complex. These are the examples that are being utilized as reductants. The redox process can plausibly be accomplished through various routes for polyatomic bridging ligands, while incoming metal binds with just one of the diverse bridging ligands available. Reaction between pentaamine cobalt and the substituted amine, that is NC6H4CONH2, and the charge of this complex is 3 positive. So, it is an analog of CONH3 whole 5 Cl type of system, and another counterpart is chromium hexa-aqua 2 positive. So these possesses these two redox couples are possessing two probable remote binding sites. The activated complex has been structurally authenticated that incorporates binding of chromium hexa-aqua 2 positive complex with the remote carbonyl moiety. A major deliberation deals with the atomic geometry upon chelation with the activated complex in due course of the reaction. The general representation of inner sphere reaction is metal 3 positive L5X. X could be the ligand that is capable of bridging with the another complex, plus M2 plus Y6. Y is another ligand, X is another ligand, and L5 is another ligand. And under acidic medium, it leads to the formation of M2 plus L5 N positive plus M3 plus Y6X. So it is clearly evident that the X, which was initially with the metal 3 positive, has been transferred to the metal which was in 2 positive charges. However, upon electron transfer, removal of X from M3 plus converts the metal to M2 plus, while the one that was in M2 plus has now been converted to M3 plus. So L denotes for ligand, that is generally ammonia. X is a bridging ligand like, you know, chlorine, bromine, cyanide, thiocyanate, etc. And Y is the ligand, generally water molecule. So the representative reaction is cobalt pentamine chloride 2 positive and chromium hexa-aqua complex, where chromium is plus 2 oxidation state, and it comes into the contact with water under acidic medium, that is hydronium H3O positive, and it leads to the formation of cobalt hexa-aqua complex 2 positive plus chromium penta-aqua complex having chloride in its coordination sphere, and its charge is 2 plus, means the chromium from 2 plus is converted to plus 3, and the cobalt from 3 plus is converted to cobalt 2 positive, and leaving to the ammonium cations in the solution. The above reaction, which involves inner sphere path, proceeds with appreciably high rate. The rate is noted as 6 into 10 to the power 5 mole inverse second inverse. However, if we replace Cl by NH3 from cobalt 3 complex, such as we are not using CO NH3 whole 5 Cl, rather we are using CO NH3 whole 6, and we are proceeding the reaction in the same analogous reaction conditions, it forms CO H2O whole 6 2 positive and Cr H2O whole 6 3 positive, and the electron transfer in this case also has taken place. But if you see, this reaction proceeds through outer sphere path with considerable slower rate, that is 10 to the power minus 3 mole inverse second inverse. So what does it mean? Means the chlorine atom, chlorine ligand attached with the cobalt center, where the cobalt is plus 3 in oxidation state in the previous case, and in this case where cobalt is attached with the hexa ammonia complex, rest of the reaction is same. So that previous reaction where chlorine is in the coordination sphere of the cobalt proceeds in a quite higher rate, while when it is substituted by ammonia and it becomes cobalt 3 plus inert D6 system, the reaction proceeds not through inner sphere, rather through outer sphere type of mechanism, and with a considerably slower rate of reaction. So this comparative inner sphere and outer sphere reaction pathways strongly recommended the presence of a bridging ligand in one of the metal complex reactants to proceed the reaction by a inner sphere pathway. So now the question is, what kind of ligands are there to our knowledge that can act as bridging ligands? So these are basically chloride anion, bromide anion, iodine anion, hydroxy anion, thiocyanate anion, it is in an imbedded manner, azide anion or cyanide anion. So these type of systems can be acted as bridging ligand, although there is a possibility of other ligands that can act as a bridging ligand in course of the electron transfer reaction. The examples are pyrazine, where nitrogen is present at 1 and 4 in the benzene ring, 4,4-dibipyridyl, two pyridyl rings are fused through para position, and N-methyl pyridine, that is N-methyl at the para position. So these systems can also act as a bridging ligand, and their rate of reactions can be accelerated or diminished. So as far as the mechanism of inner sphere redox reaction is concerned, the general consideration of inner sphere redox reactions are, first, both the metal complexes should connect with the bridging ligand during the course of substitution. One of the reacting species should have a ligand that can form a bridge between the metal complexes. The bridging ligand formation is basically intermediate, therefore it is occasionally called ligand bridged mechanism. For example, water and ammonia are moderate ligands, but these cannot serve as bridge ligand because ammonia contains just one pair of electrons, although water contains two pair of electrons and can act as a bridge system, but it is not reported, whereas high charge density on Cl- and Cn- can act as a bridge ligand. Second is the transfer of electron, as well as sometimes transfer of ligand, takes place depending upon the group of ligands attached with the reactants. However, inner sphere redox reactions are slower relative to that of the outer sphere kind of reaction. So it could be noted that the inner sphere reactions are generally slower than that of the outer sphere reactions. Finally, the products are separated to form inert complexes. So there are three steps in inner sphere type of reactions. So the common mechanism is when L5M3+X, that is oxidant, is, you know, having the interaction with the reductant, that is M prime 2 positive. Why I am using M prime means the metal centers are different in this case, and Y5, that is water molecule basically. So it leads to the formation of L5M3+ bridged by X ligand forms L5M3+X M prime 2 Y5, and one of the ligand, that is Y, in general water, is liberated away. When this is called actually precursor formation, then this precursor formation undergoes electron transfer process by a bridging ligand and forms L5M2 positive X M prime 3 Y5. Now again that liberated Y, in general water, comes into the contact with the system after electron transfer has taken place and forms L5M2 positive X M prime 3 positive Y5, and then this complex undergoes dissociation and forms L5M2Y plus XM prime 3 Y5. Now, Y in contact with this precursor complex, that is in association with L5M2 plus XM prime 3 plus Y5, undergoes dissociation to form L5M2X and M 3 plus Y6. So the bridging ligand mediates the inner sphere electron transfer process. It is evident from the general mechanism. So this is general mechanism. The first, a ligand that shares are bridged between oxidant and reductant, both in the precursor and successor complex. Second, the electron transfer takes place between both the metals only after activation through bridging of the ligand. And the third is the transfer of ligand may also occur between metal complexes, however it is not an essential requirement. So what are the fundamental for inner sphere mechanism? One of the reacting metal complexes, that is generally an oxidant, has at least one ligand that can bridge simultaneously between both the metal ions, the oxidant and the reductant. The metal complex usually, that is reductant, must be labile enough for the substitution reaction so that one of the ligand from it can be dissociated, displaced by the bridging ligand, so that it can form a bridged structure with the corresponding counterpart. Another schematic representation for inner sphere mechanism is that oxidant is bridged with, you know, connected with X, plus reductant is connected with water, and it forms oxidant X reductant. In a simple way, oxidant X, that is a bridging ligand, reductant, and the water is going away. It is called formation of a precursor complex. Now, oxidant bridged with X reductant further undergoes electron transfer process by activation through bridged ligand and forms OX minus X Red plus, oxidant minus X reductant plus. So now the electron transfer has taken place. So now this complex oxidant minus X reductant plus further comes into the contact with water and forms oxidant water negative plus reductant X positive. So it is called separation of the products. Therefore, the overall reaction can be written as oxidant bonded with X plus reductant forms oxidant bridged X with reductant, then OX minus, that is oxidant minus plus reductant plus, and the rate of reaction is observed for this kind of one step reaction, overall reaction, is K1 K3 by K1 plus K2 into OX X and Red. So that is oxidant plus reductant, both are playing the role for the rate determining step, and the rate of reaction can be obtained by OX X and Red both. Examples are given one by one with their mechanism. That the simple known reaction, that is cobalt pentamine chloride, the cobalt is in plus 3 oxidation state, comes into the contact with chromium hexaqua 2 positive under acidic condition, leads to the formation of cobalt hexaqua complex, where cobalt is reduced to plus 2 oxidation state, and chromium has oxidized to the plus 3 oxidation state, and the chlorine ligand is going to bind from the cobalt to chromium in this stage. So cobalt 3 plus low spin is inert because of the d6 electronic configuration, while chromium 2, that is d4 configuration, is labile. So the oxidant is inert and the reductant is labile, forming cobalt 2 plus, now high spin complex, labile d7, and chromium with plus 3 oxidation state, that is d3 and inert. So the one that was labile has converted to inert form, and the one that was inert has been converted to the labile complex. So the role played by Cl only, therefore the d6 inert complex has been activated. So the mechanism of this reaction is simply cobalt pentamine chlorine binds with chromium in a bridged manner, and H2O is liberated. This first step is quite fast. Rather, the precursor complex formed in the first step, having bridged chlorine, is undergoing electron transfer process, and this process is quite slow. And the cobalt 3 has been converted to 2, and the chromium 2 has been converted to chromium 3. Now this electron transferred complex is now undergoing dissociation to cobalt 2 plus pentamine H2O and chromium 2 H2O5Cl. So the slowest step for such reactions are electron transfer processes, which are indeed rate determining step as well. However, in general, rate determining step may be electron transfer step or bridging, bridge breaking step, bridge forming step or anything. Majority of inner sphere redox reactions exhibit second order kinetics. The energetics of above mentioned reactions is, you know, if you see the energetics of cobalt pentamine chlorine complex with reacting with chromium hexa aqua 2 positive. Now the transition state that is formed is dissociation of one water from chromium, and chlorine is now having a bridged formation with the chromium, and that is transition state. So the plot goes like that, that transition state achieved, and then when this complex was, you know, achieved, precursor complex, the energy was minimized, and then again for the dissociation of this electron transfer process, after electron transfer process, this bridged complex is dissociated, then again goes to the transition state and ultimately comes to the product where cobalt is now bonded with water and reduced to plus 2, chromium is converted to the corresponding plus 3, and it is also bonded with water, and it, you know, possesses the chlorine bridged ligand. Second reaction is analogous cobalt pentamine, but the bridge ligand in this case is bromine, not chlorine, and another metal that is reductant is vanadium hexa aqua complex. Under analogous condition, the reaction was proceed, and the cobalt 3 was reduced to 2 and the vanadium 2 was reduced to vanadium, you know, oxidized to vanadium 3. So the mechanism is similar as I told just in the previous reaction. And what happens in this case, the relative study shows that the first step, formation of the precursor complex, was fast. The electron transfer process in this case was also fast. Rather, the dissociation of this complex, bridged complex, to the corresponding reduced and oxidized species after electron transfer process is slow. While in the previous case, we have seen that the electron transfer process was slow. So in this case, the rate determining step has been changed. So the relative studies on above reactions are chlorine and bromine, it is quite clear that the bridging group has subtle influence on the rate constant, and the rate is analogous to the exchange of water molecule. The slowest step is the dissociation of water, which is also rate determining step, not a bridge forming step or electron transfer step. So in summary, the detailed introduction about inner sphere reaction is given with deciding parameters to distinguish them from the outer sphere kind of reaction. The stability of reacting partners, which is also responsible where formation of precursor complex will be faster or slower, has been discussed. The stability of precursor complex, that is bridged complex, has also been discussed, since it facilitates or does not facilitate the electron transfer depending on the stability of the counterparts. The bridging or sharing of the ligand is very important as far as inner sphere type of mechanism are concerned, and it enhances the rate of inner sphere reactions, although it is not compulsory for all the inner sphere kind of reactions.